Hey guys, welcome back to Tank Garage. My name is Frank, and I'll be the man behind the camera. Yes, it's winter, guys. Last few videos were actually done a lot in advance. These videos were all filmed during springtime when I came back from California. And I kind of haven't made a new video ever since, but you guys still had weekly content to push out. So hopefully you guys have enjoyed it. Today, we're working on the XC70 T6. Like you guys can see, I've already got one mirror cap off on this side. And the reason why is we will be attacking this little part right here. Before the video starts, make sure you like, subscribe, and turn on post notifications so you don't miss any uploads from Tank Garage. Okay guys, I have done this mod quite a couple times. We've done it on the S60R, on the S80V8. Mech has also done it on the S80 T6, if I'm not too... He has done the LED license plate lights, but we've done it on the S80 V8. We've also done it on my old S80 T6 before the channel was actually a thing. But these are going to be blacked out sequential turn signals. Oh, that's that little thing. I thought it were broken. Thank God, that would have not started the video well. So these are blacked out sequential turn signals. You guys have probably seen this before. But yeah, we're doing it on the XC70 T6 as well because LED is the way to go. And while we're there, we're also gonna do the puddle lights underneath, but that's gonna be for another video for you guys. All right, so let's get right into it. I'll see you guys onto the tripod. So we're doing today the sequential turn signals. First thing that you want to do, guys, I went ahead and removed one side just to see how it's done on the inside, because like you guys know, we're also doing the puddle lights. So I'll do this in kind of like a two-step video. We'll do this in one video and I'll just do two separate videos for the puddle lights and the LED turn signals. So first thing that you guys want is get yourself a kit of these LED turn signals. So AliExpress, Amazon, eBay, you can find them everywhere. Just type in what you need. So XC70 2010 in my option. And yeah, you get a little tool just like this that comes inside of the kit. Let's see if the camera focuses on it. There we go. So it's a little pry tool just like that. And you're gonna go ahead and, so your mirror is gonna be on the car like this, right? So what you're gonna do is you're gonna slide your little tool at the bottom right corner. So this is where the light connects to it, right? This is the bottom right corner. You're gonna slide your tool underneath and then you're gonna slowly, be careful not to break the clips inside because there's a bunch of clips inside that you don't wanna break, right? So you're gonna move your tool slowly on the inside and then all of a sudden, it's just gonna pop off by itself. In this case, there is not a single clip that's broken on my mirror. So yeah, I did a good job at it. After that, once you're done doing that, I'm gonna put this in my pocket. Go ahead and close the door. You can go ahead and remove the mirror cap. Once the mirror cap is fully removed, I'm just gonna zoom in a tiny little bit for you guys and bring you guys ever so slightly closer. Let's see right here. Just like that. You are going to have two tabs, guys. There's gonna be one tab at the bottom right over here, technically the bottom left if you're looking at the left mirror. And then it slides into the top right here as well. So what you wanna do is you wanna be careful not to break this little plastic tab because yeah, you don't wanna be replacing that. What you wanna do is press down right over here. There is a little ledge that you could press down. Let's see if I can actually zoom in and show you guys what it looks like. Let's see here. Let's see if the camera will focus. Right there, can you guys see it? Right over here, there's a little plastic tab that you have to squeeze either a screwdriver or the plastic pry tool in my option that I have here in it. So what's that gonna do? Well, it's going to separate this little part right here from the clip, which is right there, and then you'll be able to slide the mirror. Technically, it slides up and out this way. So let's go and do that, and I'll show you guys after what it looks like once the signal is turned out. So, now that I've got the unit off, guys, like you see, no clips broken. Let's see if this focuses, please. Camera, focus, thank you. This little clip is brand new, not broken. And the clip on the outside right here is also not broken. Just like we want it, you wanna put that to the side and you're going to have your little turn signal right here. Pretty much it's a seal that you have to separate, so just pull apart the transparent part and this one. What you wanna do is just remove the bulb. So you just pull on the bulb. This is how the bulb looks. So it's just a simple pull in and out, and then you will have access to the turn signal connector. Now you wanna go ahead and get your new light. I'll go do that and I'll be right back and I'll show you guys when you plug it in. You wanna test it out, of course, to make sure that the turn signal works. And then you just clip it back in. It's that simple, not too complicated. Right now I'm just looking in the area to see if I can actually push out the puddle light at the same time that we're here. So I'll see you guys once I get everything in. So I actually figured out, guys, that you have no choice but to remove the mirror so that you can actually access the puddle light underneath. Now that I've got the connection made here with the LED turn signal, we're gonna remove the little plastic protective right here. I've also made sure that it does work. So go inside, turn on your hazards, make sure that it does work. Well, because you don't wanna go there ever again, right? And then just gonna set this to the side. So to put it back in, okay, you wanna start off by the bottom part and then you wanna get this side part right here. But what's actually a little tiny complicated is going to be to clip it in sideways, and then there you go. That's how easy it is. So it is actually easier than the OEM one. It doesn't hold as strong as the OEM one, I have to admit. But once this part is put in, you can go ahead and put your mirror cap back on and it should be fine. So like you guys can see, it's pretty easy to take out, but don't forget, you also have the mirror cap that comes and sits on top of this part. Now I'm just wondering if this is gonna sit properly. There you go. Once everything is clipped in, like you guys can see, this is gonna sit properly over here and it's gonna sit at the bottom. So shouldn't have any fitment issues with that. I did order the correct one for my car. So we'll go ahead, do the other side and show you guys what it looks like in the end. You guys have pretty much already seen what this looks like, but very easy install, guys. Took me about 10 minutes. Like you guys can see here, there's a little gap in between that part of the mirror and the bottom. Good question, probably engineering flaw that they did. It is kind of loose, but again, I'll see, once I do put the mirror cap on, I'll see if it flickles around and moves around, because, I mean, it shouldn't, but we'll see. Always gotta make sure, guys, these are, you know, Chinese parts, so yeah, gotta make sure before you install them. All right, so I do have the assembly that's in. There is ever so slightly play, guys. I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but this is about how much it moves. It's not OEM, so the fitment is not perfect. I could probably squeeze in something over here. Like you guys can see, it's not completely perfect, but hey, again, in the end, this was a $10 or $15 part. Cannot complain. It does change the look. It does change how it handles how the light appears to you in the end. Is it actually gonna move while I drive? I doubt it, I doubt it. When you put the mirror cap back on, super, super important, you wanna start by the bottom side. You wanna slide in the two bottom pins, which are right here and right here. And then you'll see the whole mirror is gonna shift to the side, and your ledge on top, there's gonna be a little bit of a gap, let's say about half an inch, well, let's say half a centimeter of a gap on top. And you just wanna press down on the areas in order for it to go down properly. So once that is done, we can move over to the next side and finish that off. And then I'll go ahead and move on to the puddle lights. So I'll see you guys at the final results. Enjoy. I woke up in.
Nobody always on the fucking job. I got no hobbies, got the city fucking with me, cause I'm homegrown, vibing out more than my.
Alrighty, guys, what do y'all think of the final result? I think it looks pretty damn good. Pay attention, roll back to the B-rolls, guys. The actual LED bar is floating inside of the assembly, which is kind of cool. I don't know if the camera will capture it. Let's see here. Definitely not. It is very, very hard to show on camera since the housing is black, but it's basically floating in there. It's not connected to the front side. It's actually in the middle, and I guess they have some type of, like, I don't know, plastic things that hold it down. But I think it looks really, really good, guys. It gives a deeper tone black to the mirror and kind of just makes the side of the car flow a little bit better.
We're going to attack those little bad boys here that are completely oxidated and out of touch. And that little part right here, but hey, I'm not going to talk too much. So this fits with the trims on top, fits with the windows that I'm going to tint. Again, because the rear windows are not tinted enough, in my opinion, for a wagon, the fronts as well. But yeah, now we're going to move on to the puddle lights, which are going to be in the next video for you guys. So make sure you follow the channel, guys. Subscribe. Please share this to your friends if they have Volvos like this. This is the same tutorial, by the way, for every single P3 generation of the S80, V70, XC90, and XC70. It's the same for all three of them. It's not the same unit, of course, because the mirrors are different on the XCs and non-XCs versions, but it is the same way to remove the mirror cap. So if you guys need any info on that, make sure to comment down below. Let me know what you think of the video. And if you guys enjoyed, make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on post notifications so you don't miss any uploads from Tank Garage. See ya, boys.